Hi everybody, today is March 2nd, 2013. There's been a lot of talk about the United States to drop mice down on Guam to get rid of the snake problem. This article from CNN is only part of what they're going to do. If you're a brown tree snake, those deadly rodents will soon be falling from the sky over Guam's Anderson Air Force Base, and it could be your last meal. I didn't know snakes would eat dead rodents. Does anyone know? I always thought they had if you had a pet snake that you fed it live mice, I didn't know they would eat dead mice. Because they're dead, they're not alive, but they're dropping. That's because the U.S. Department of Agriculture is planning to pack each mouse with acetaminophen, the generic equivalent of Tylenol, which can kill snakes, doesn't mean it will, a snake in 72 hours. The drug-laced mice will be taped to pieces of cardboard, which in turn will be attached to streamers that will be dropped from helicopters over more than 100 acres of the Air Force Base in the Pacific Island. The bombing campaign is expected to begin this spring. Dan Weiss, the USDA Assistant Operators Director on Guam, told the local Pacific News Center. It replicates a smaller-scale test drop on a naval base in Guam in 2010, it said. The goal, he said, is to eradicate the brown tree mice from the island. Now here's a little bit more information from another article that was published on February 22nd. It shows mice with little parachutes, but that's not the case. There are dead mice taped to cardboard with streamers to slow their descent, and the hope is that they'll be caught up in the trees so that the snakes will eat them. Guam is being overrun by millions of snakes. The U.S. government hopes airdropping drugged dead mice can solve the problem. Brown tree snakes came to Guam naturally on a plane and on boats. In the 60 years since the arrival, the brown tree snake has ate almost all the birds, and there's only a few hundred birds left on the island. The decimation of the bird population, in turn, has led to an explosion in spider population. During the rainy season, there are 40 times more webs on Guam than on nearby islands. The snakes, which can grow 10 feet long, have also bitten residents and even knocking out power by slithering into power lines. The poisoned mice targeting the snakes will be attached to little parachutes. Well, that's not true. They're going to be tied to pieces of cardboard or glued to it. I don't know. How will a snake eat a mouse that's dead attached to a piece of cardboard? Which it hopes they will get caught up in the trees where the snakes live. Natural Wildlife Research Center is working on developing a more sophisticated solution as a first step in development of an artificial attractant. NWRC scientists successfully characterized the odor of a dead and decomposing mouse. The next step will be to develop a suitable matrix in which this mouse essence can be embedded. I wonder what kind of money they're spending on this. Chemical cues involved in brown tree snakes' behavior, however, are complex, and cues that elicit strong responses in the laboratory often have diminished effects in the field. So far, artificial matrix compounds as diverse as tofu, plaster of Paris, and gelatin have showed promise as attractive lures, but snakes have shown only limited interest. Why so much effort being poured into solving this problem? The brown tree snake could be headed to Hawaii next, despite extensive screening effort. 8 brown tree snakes have been found on Oahu since 1981, hitchhiking on aircraft from Guam. An economic analysis found that proliferation of the brown tree snakes in Hawaii could cost over $2 billion annually from medical incidents, power outages, and decreases in tourism. The problem illustrates the substantial economic and health risks posed by invasive species in an increasingly global economy. Other risks include the emerald ash borer on imported Valentine's Day flowers, the brown marmorated stink bug on citrus fruits, and killer algae that grows in tropical fish tanks. So I'd like to know, how are these dead mice attached to this cardboard that these snakes are supposed to ingest? And will snakes in the wild eat a dead mouse attached to a piece of cardboard? All right, bookmark my site. I'll keep everyone up to date. Please stay safe, and I'll talk to you later. God bless y'all. Bye.